baseball under the lights of Wrigley Field in Chicago. Tonight, an intriguing matchup between the San Diego Padres and the Chicago Cubs.
And now, your 2021.
It's baseball on the show,
Chicago,
and it's coming up next.
Cubs.
Kyle Hendricks gets the starting nod for the Cubs in this one. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, Matty V, this guy lives and dies with one pitch, and that's that powerhouse sinker. Guys often relate it to like trying to hit a bowling ball. When it's good, it's usually at the knees and below, and he's really easy to figure out if he's going to be on. If in the first inning you see a steady diet of ground balls and keeping his infielders involved, there's a pretty good chance he's going to have a rock-solid game.
And that'll bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Swing and a miss, and it's a ball and two strikes here. Expected to get a little cooler as we go on, but the temperature at game time, 68 degrees. Set to deal on a ball and two strikes. He takes the changeup the other way out toward right center. Hayward has a read on it. One away.
Not accepted. The center fielder, number two, Trent Grisham.
So one out and nobody aboard, and that brings up Trent Grisham. The 1-1. Misses, ball two.
Well, the key for him on the mound is to keep the ball down. Certainly, hollow of the knee or lower. Sinker changeup guy, if he's going to succeed against this lineup, he's got to keep the ball down.
In the on-deck circle is Manny Machado. He'll bat next. Here it is on 3-1. On the ground to the right side. Scooped up. And there's out number two. Here's Manny Machado now. A Silver Slugger winner a year ago in the National League. Two now as that one's fouled off.
Put that in a memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Popped him up. Rizzo over to his left, and he's got it for the final out of the frame. So a fairly painless top of the first, and now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. Chris Paddock, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, it's hard to have all four of your pitches on, but I think if this guy can have two or three of his four pitches and have command of them, he's going to have a really good game.
So stepping in is Jock Peterson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Lifted down the line and left, and he is going to have extra bases here to start the home first, and he's going to get to second now with nobody out.
Man, it looked like the pitcher was trying to get him to go fishing in a pitch out of the strike
zone.
He went for it all right, but he managed to catch all of that baseball, lacing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
So now to the plate, Chris Bryant. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Grisham is under it to make the catch for out number one.
That is third. The shortstop, Javier Baez.
The next Cub up, Javier Baez. First appearance for him here with the leadoff man still at second and one gone now. The 2-2. Hit softly on the ground to third. Fielded cleanly in time to first, and there are two away. So in now for Chicago, Anthony Rizzo. Opportunity for him here to pick up that runner from second with two away. The set and the 2-1. The catcher wanted it down, and they got him to chase it for strike two. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
You would think in this situation, maybe with a base open, he'd just pitch around him and put him on first. But not with the guy in the on-deck circle. He's going to attack this hitter.
Lifted in the air out to right. After it is Myers. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. As he arrives at second without a play, as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play.
This is why it's so important to give your cleanup hitter an opportunity to hit with runners in scoring position. He does just what he's supposed to do, lacing a double and driving in a run, just like you draw it up.
At the plate, Wilson Contreras, 2-2 to the Cubs catcher.
Hey, I love that pitch right there. Better execution after just giving up an extra base hit.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Reined in. Throw in time, and the side is retired. The Cubs get a run courtesy of Anthony Rizzo. We'll head to the top of the second. It's now 1-0 Chicago. Second inning set to go, and here comes the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Leadoff knock right there, Dan. How frustrating is it to let that leadoff guy get on?
Boy, every pitcher, you want to get that first guy out, D-Row. The chances of scoring runs are so much more slim when you get that first guy out. Traffic on the bases, now you have to pitch out of the stretch. It's never easy for the pitcher.
Standing in now, Jake Cronenworth. That's lifted the other way out to left. Peterson arranged to his left as he tracks this one down in left center for the first out.
Batting six, the right fielder, number five.
Here's Will Myers. His matchup numbers with Hendricks. He's got five base hits in 19 tries. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hayward has a read on it. Two down. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And Jurickson Profar will be the next to bat. Right side. Rizzo is there. And he'll step on the bag himself. And the inning is over. One left for San Diego. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Last half of the second set to go, and set to go is the third baseman, Matt Duffy. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a blooper to the right side.
Cronenworth
ranging into the outfield. He can't get there as it falls in.
I know this guy isn't known for his hitting prowess, but that's a nice job right there. Getting a single on a 3-2 pitch in the middle of the zone. Grab your glove and flash some leather.
Into the box now, Jason Hayward. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning.
That was some nice execution on that pitch. Spotted it nicely down around the bottom of the zone.
The second
baseman.
And
when you do that, especially with two strikes, not a lot of guys are going to hurt you. You're going to get a lot of ground balls and swings and misses down there.
At the plate now, David Bote. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
The 2-1 home. And he fouls this one off. The 2-2. And this one's in the dirt. But it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Swing and a little blooper to center. Grisham charging forward, but he won't get there. It falls in. And he'll move up to third now. Runners at the corners here with one away.
Batting ninth, the pitcher, Kyle Hendricks.
To the plate now, Kyle Hendricks. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 1-2 pitch. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
The left fielder.
So next to bat will be the left-handed hitting Jock Peterson. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Set and the 2-1 to 2-2 now. Did well just to make contact there as he spoils off a good changeup. The 2-2. And that's ball three now as it just misses below the zone. Chris Bryant would be next. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. Second inning here as the Cubs lead this one early 1-0. Hit hard on the ground towards second. And that's through for a base hit. And that'll plate their second run of the game as they take a 2-0 lead.
Now batting.
So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle his guy down. So it's first and second with two men gone. And into bat next, former National League MVP Chris Bryant. Two men are on with two men out. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Full count still. The next 3-2. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. So it's a run on three hits, no errors, and two men left on. Set for the start of the inning, and that brings up Austin Nola.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
Here's the 2-1 home. Hot shot on the ground is short. Baez has it. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Batting
up next, it'll be the pitcher for the Padres, Chris Paddock. One out, nobody on. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
High in the air out towards shallow right. Hayward coming on. He's got it. A nice play there. Two away. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that will bring up Fernando Tatis Jr. The 1-1. To short, hit hard. Baez fields it cleanly. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. Three up, three down for San Diego. They're down 2-0. Welcome back to the north side of Chicago, back here at Wrigley Field as we check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. It's still pretty early in the game, but they've seen a lot of pitches already. And he thinks the two runs they've pushed across so far is just the beginning, given the quality of the at-bats they're putting together.
Okay, thank you, Heidi. Bottom of the third now, and with it comes Javi Baez to the plate. A ball and two strikes.
Hey, I don't mind that take right there. That was a nasty breaking ball. Started outside the zone, popped back inside the zone. Good spin rate on it. Move on to the next pitch.
Fouled away. Again, a 1-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal. You can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he could go in right here.
And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted.
Now batting.
So bases are empty with one gone. And into bat next, the left-handed hitting first baseman, Rizzo. Anthony Rizzo. Lifted the other way to left center. There to play it is Profar, and there are two away.
Up next to the top.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras.
Contreras.
And an off-speed pitch swung on and missed, and with that, the side is retired. Cubs are down in order, but they're on top 2-0. Set for the start of the fourth, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Trent Grisham. Now the 1-1 pitch is looked at for ball number two. All even now, 2-2. into the windup and the pitch.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
And this is strike three called, says Clyde Washington. Might have looked a bit low, but that's out number one.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
So now to the plate, Manny Machado, swing and a line drive. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Had to wait back on the changeup, and he did a good job just to make contact. He'll try again, 1-2. Ground ball, left side. He's right there. And there are two away now.
Now batter.
And it'll be the cleanup spot for the Padres, Eric Hosmer. Halfway to 100 pitches, here it is. Grounded to short. There's Baez. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Padres down in order. They trail it here, 2-0. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And that means the corner infielder Matt Duffy will bat next. The 1-1. Misses for the second ball.
I got 2-1 to count.
Sent on the ground out to second. He's got it. And he will whip this one over to first in time for the out.
Now batter, the right fielder.
Now to bat, Jason Hayward. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. And they'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Fastball didn't miss by much, and it's a full count now, 3-2. David Bodie, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field.
Most guys assume they're getting a 3-2 fastball in that count right there, guys. But he was able to keep his hands back, keep his nose in there, and battle for a knock.
Into the box, David Bodie. Off and running is Hayward. To second for one, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Nothing happening there for the Cubbies, but they hold a 2-0 lead. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point. And he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Jake Cronenworth. High in the air out to center field. Bryant is there, and he has it for the first out. So here's Will Myers. No runs, just one hit. No errors in the ballgame for the Padres. And this will be fouled away. This is foul right side. The 1-2 pitch. Looked like the fastball got away from him there. It's ball two.
That was a tempting pitch to swing at right there. A big power guy like this really wants something that he can elevate and drive out of the ballpark.
And that's the second out. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And Jurickson Profar will be the next to bat. 1-1.
Man, this guy has retired a whole slew right now. I think what he needs to do is just stay focused and keep attacking the game plan like he has up to this point, because everything he's done has worked.
Two out, nobody on. High fly ball out to straightaway center. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. They trail things here 2-0. Set now for the bottom of the fifth, and set to stand in is the veteran pitcher, Kyle Hendricks. The 1-1. Oh, and this one has hit a ton out to center. Racing back the center fielder into the bleachers and gone. So it's a solo shot to dead center, and the Cubs have taken a 3-0 lead.
You don't see this very often off of this starting pitcher. This guy's not used to giving up some bombs, so I'm sure that'll be a wake-up call, and he'll start throwing some better pitches.
Plate, Jock Peterson. And he takes strike three called on the fastball, one gone. Here's Chris Bryant now. He's hitless in his two at bats so far. Swung on and missed that strike two. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Three runs, seven hits. No errors so far for the Cubbies. Looked like the cut fastball there, and he got him to swing through it for the second out.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys, because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
Fouled off.
It's going to be back to some serious tee work if he can't put that pitch in play right in his wheelhouse.
Breaking ball misses the corner. Two balls and two strikes. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. One in the inning, and it comes from a rather unlikely power source. Five innings complete. It's 3-0 Chicago. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and that brings up Austin Nola. Here comes the 1-2.
Man, this at bat has changed quickly from 0-2 now to 2-2. A good job of plate discipline by this hitter, not chasing those pitches just off the plate.
Into the windup and the pitch. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first out.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strike up out there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
Jorge Mateo will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
San Diego, number three, Jorge Mateo.
Bases are empty, one man out. Two and one. Mateo is a guy you have to keep an eye on in the batter's box. He's definitely been known to drop down a bunt from time to time. That's something he's really good at. Takes that one a little bit low. Three balls and a strike now.
Hey, he's had great command all day. Want to see how aggressive he is in the zone with a three ball count.
And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
This is only their second base runner of the game after that earlier hit. Tough to score when you don't have anyone on base, so we'll see if they can get something going here.
The San Diego batting order turns over and set to go. Fernando Tatis Jr., 0 for 2 on his line thus far. A bouncer up the middle. And that gets through for a one-out base hit. And he's safe.
This is their time right here. This starting pitcher has been on point all day. Runs have been at a premium. They have an opportunity to do something special right here.
In now, Trent Grisham lifted down the line in left. On the move is Peterson. He won't have a play, and this should finally get him on the board. They'll cash in here as the run is in to score from third.
Now batter.
Hey, you tip your hat to the batter for finding a way to find some green grass out there, but, man, that has to frustrate you, Dan, an executed pitch right there.
It does. Anytime you make a good pitch, and off the bat it certainly didn't look like it was going to fall in for a base hit. You make a good pitch, but you don't necessarily always get the kind of results you want as a pitcher.
And it's one and two.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
Changeup, and that fades down and away, two and two.
Number three hole hitter up right now. Cleanup guy on deck, two ball, two strike count. I think pitcher wants to make something happen right here.
Here now the 2-2. Hard hit ball to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And he's going to score with ease as the throw will be too late.
He doubled up on that one, Danny. Back-to-back changeups. Nice job by the batter right there staying on that pitch.
That's one of the things that this pitcher will do, though, Mark. His changeup is so good, he's not afraid to throw it back-to-back pitches.
Standing in now, Eric Hosmer. That's lifted the other way out to left. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow! And a score from third, the tying run.
The batter number nine, second base.
Into the box now, Jake Cronenworth. Goes the other way as this is lined to left. And that'll get down for a base hit. Throw comes in quickly from left, so even on the hit and run, they'll hold things to first and second here. Digging in now for San Diego, Will Myers. He's got a chance to add on to what's already been a big inning for them.
Yeah, two on here and three on the board already. They've absolutely come out and forced the issue of this inning. Matt, a hit here could really fire up that dugout.
Squared that one up just a little late. Three runs already home here. Hard sinker misses, 2-2.
Now 2-2. This is the pitch where you want to attack the zone. If you go 3-2, then you put the runners in motion.
Two and two. Here it is. Fly ball right down the line and left. Peterson has a read on it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. So three runs on four hits, no errors, and a couple of men left. To the bottom of the sixth we go. 4, 5, and 6 coming up, and we are all tied at 3 apiece. Ryan Weathers enters to do the pitching in the bottom of the sixth.
Now pitching for the Padres, number 40, Ryan Weathers.
And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. Nope. Fastball well outside. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
Well, that's ball three, and the Cubs right now, they're looking for base runners. Hey, they'd love to get a leadoff walk.
And it's fouled away. And that one misses, so the leadoff man will head down to first on ball four to start the bottom of the sixth.
Well, he's a youngster. You can see he's a little nervous out there. Some people call it butterflies, but to him it probably feels like pterodactyls are flying around in his gut. Going to be interesting to see if he can settle down here.
Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Runner aboard at first with nobody out in a 3-3 tie. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. There's a two-seam fastball that's fought off foul off to the right. Another try at 2-2. And this is on the ground to first. Could be two. Oh, but the feed to the shortstop is off the mark.
Well, it's really hard to complain about this one because that's one of the hardest double plays to turn. The first baseman has to deal with the runner headed to second, and he sometimes shields you from throwing where you want to make the throw. They should have made it, but that's a tough play all the way around.
At the plate now, Matt Duffy hit hard on the ground to second. To second for one, over to Hosmer, a double play.
Oh, that's a rally killer right there. They were in great shape with two on and nobody out. But the double play is the last thing you want in that situation. Just a runner at third now, but there's two outs.
Stepping in now, Jason Hayward. And he takes a called strike two.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Now here's a fly ball. Well hit. And that's just shy of the baskets and off the ivy. And the runner from third crosses the plate. It's a 4-3 game. So much of this game is situational hitting, guys. Nice job there.
Yeah, you've got to find a way to pick your teammates up when you're given the chance. And he doesn't try to do too much right here. He just takes what's there. Safely on second, and his buddy is high-fiving teammates in the dugout.
So now to the plate, David Bodie. Fastball taken inside for a ball. 2-1 now. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Cubs pick up a run on the RBI double. Bottom third of the order, 7-8-9, due up to start the seventh. It's now 4-3 Chicago. Seventh inning ready to roll. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Jurickson Profar. Now the 2-1 pitch. Will not catch the zone, ball three.
Great situation right here, leading off the inning. You got to find a way to get on base any way possible. But I don't like to take the aggression away from hitters. If it's in your zone, I want you swinging.
3-2, full count. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. And the sinking fastball called strike three, and that's out number one.
Nice job there taking care of the leadoff hitter via the strikeout. I'll tell you, in a one-run game, especially this late, getting that first guy in the inning is so important. It changes the whole complexion of the inning, so that was a big out.
At the plate, Austin Nola. Bounced towards the second baseman. Fielded cleanly. Throw on to first, two gone. Tommy Pham will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run.
Number 28, Tommy Pham.
This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. So after the three spot last time around, he's able to bounce back and hang a zero here. Get out the microphone. Stretch time here at Wrigley. It's the Cubs 4 and the Padres 3. Craig Stammen will take over on the mound to start the bottom of the seventh.
Number 34, Craig Stammen.
Number 62 is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on. And when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Standing in now, Jock Peterson. And a check swing here as he couldn't help himself, and it's ruled strike two. Here comes the 1-2.
Can we be honest here? That was a terrible pitch. That was right over the heart of the plate, two strikes on the guy. He is lucky he's getting this pitch back.
And it's another K. So back-to-back strikeout victims to start this relief outing.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
To the plate now, Chris Bryant. Oh, and a half swing there on a pitch out of the zone indeed. It's strike two. We're in the seventh inning now of a 4-3 ball game. Hit back up the middle. Reined in. Throw in the dirt, but a good scoop at first saves an error as the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now. The Cubs lead this one 4-3. Ryan Tepera has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 18, Ryan Tepera.
Ready to begin the eighth, and up steps the big bat of Fernando Tatis Jr. The set and the 1-1 pitch. skied into very shallow right. Modi is there. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Boy, he showed some pretty good range heading pretty deep into the outfield to bring that one down. Thought the outfielder might call him off, but he clearly had it under control.
Into the box, Trent Grisham. And he looks at one in there, one and two. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Ready on one and two. And you can tell he wanted to hold off, but he swings through the inside pitch anyway, and he becomes out number two. That was a nasty-looking slider that time.
Yeah, that was really well executed, Matt. A classic strikeout pitch. You think it's fastball middle in, then it starts bearing in on your back leg, and unless you hit it out front, there's nothing much you can do with that.
In now, Manny Machado. And he fouls this one off. 4-3 our score here as we play the eighth. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Ripped down the line. But this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Now here it comes. And that's taken high for a ball. It's full now, 3-2.
Hey, this guy's a hard guy to put away. He's fouling off some tough pitches. 2-2 count, and he just seems to keep hanging right in there.
And he lays off ball four. So now the potential tying run here is aboard late in the game.
And I'm sure the manager is just fine with that. I mean, it's better to battle a slugger like that to the end and end up walking him than serving one up where he can really hurt you.
Time called here as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. Eric Hosmer to the plate now. It was an RBI sack fly for him last time through. A runner on first with two away. Got him swinging, and that's the third out. Clearly fired up to work out of that jam. Back with more from Wrigleyville right after this. Hyung Kim is going to go ahead and stay now in the ball game and play third now.
Number seven, Hyung Kim.
Now at the plate here is Javier Baez. He went down looking in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Maddie, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got to bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Got him. So he's down on strikes for the second time here tonight.
Well, at the plate, he kind of got bailed out on that previous pitch. I think it should have been a strike. Then he goes down looking, and you really can't feel too sorry for him. Not a lot of protecting with two strikes there.
So now to the plate, Anthony Rizzo swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Pitch on the way. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. Nola recovers, but no chance to get him, and he'll take first after striking out. So good awareness that time, as that'll go as a strikeout, but he's aboard on the drop third strike.
Contreras.
Striding in is Wilson Contreras. He'll attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Yeah. breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Two-one, here it is. Sinker, and that's ruled strike two. One out, one on in a one-run game. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
At the plate now, Matt Duffy. Hit out towards second, and that's in for a base hit. He's 2-for-4 now.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And if you're a pitcher right there, you can't get discouraged. Sometimes even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
Standing in now, Jason Hayward. Swing and a miss, and the count goes full 3-2. Pulled toward right center field. After it is Myers. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Cubs strand a couple, and it remains a 4-3 game. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Ninth inning save situation coming up now as they'll entrust Craig Kimbrel with the baseball here as he'll try and close things out. Jake Cronenworth will be charged with trying to start a rally in the ninth as they go to work against Kimbrel. The 1-1 home. This one's flared off to the right side. Under it is Mariznick, one away. Next to the plate for the Padres, Will Myers flew out last time up. To 2-2 now.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
Here now the 2-2. One run game here in the top of the ninth. Now Myers, a drive. This is the deep left field. That one is out of here. This game is tied. A solo shot here to left, and we are tied again. I'm excited to check the home run numbers that come out on ShowTrack because that was just one of the most impressive launches we've seen in a good while. And as the numbers come in, that ball was projected to have carried over 460 feet. An amazing show of strength. At the plate, Jurickson Profar. Down low, two balls and a strike. And now the Cubs' bullpen will start working here as both a lefty and a righty are up. The 2-1 home.
Oh, that's out.
when you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
3-1, here it is. Hit on the ground out to short. And there's out number two. That'll bring up Austin Nola. No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. That's going to even up the count at 2-2. And he chased it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. The Padres get one in the inning, and it comes on the solo home run. That'll set the stage for the bottom of the ninth. All even now at four apiece. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Austin Adams will come on to pitch now as he'll move into the eighth spot in the lineup on the double switch here. Victor Caratini will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number nine hold in the order here on that double switch. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And set to go is the second baseman, David Bote. The 3-1. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And this is down for extra bases. And there's your winning run moving into scoring position. And just like that, the winning run is into second base with a leadoff double.
Jake. He just tattoos this ball right here. Tried to sneak a fastball in on him? No way. Drives it to deep left center field gap, and that was a nice job to get the barrel around in time to score that baby up.
Stepping in now, Jake Mariznick. Counts even a 2-2 to Mariznick. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Here's the 2-2 pitch. And he takes ball three, so it's a full count now. Jock Peterson will be next. Now the 3-2 pitch. A bouncer to the left side. He's got it. And that's out number one. Here's Jock Peterson now, and he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. Question is whether they'll even pitch to him. The 1-1 pitch.
This is going to be an interesting at bat. I think he has to be pitching for a strikeout here, so we'll see what kind of sequence he uses.
Fouled away. Possible game winners at second base here with one away. Fouled off. Shin-high fastball that time, ball three.
You can certainly tell at-bats like this one frustrate the heck out of a pitcher. But you got to find a way to stay composed and execute your plan.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Boy, well hit, but out of play into the stands in deep right. Got him! And he goes down on strikes for the third time. Digging in next will be Chris Bryant. He's gone hitless to this point.
Not a great game up to this point, but none of that would matter if he could come through right here. A chance to be the hero.
Off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Got him. And that's the third time we've written a K next to his name in this one. Cubs strand one. Score remains tied at 4. Now at the plate, Victor Caratini. He'll be the one to lead it off here in the top of inning number 10. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1. Now some action out in the bullpen as a lefty and a right-hander begin throwing. The 2-1. 2-2.
I always remember John Smoltz telling me the greatest asset a closer can have is short-term memory. And this situation calls for it right here. He's got to forget that he has any traffic on a base pass and just attack the zone.
Here's the 2-2 pitch. Way inside with that one. A pretty easy take there. Now the 3-2 pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
Yeah, as they say, there's a hole in his swing in that location, so a good job there of exploiting that. That can be real hard for some guys to overcome when teams start figuring out what locations you just can't handle.
Into the box, Fernando Tatis Jr. swinging a ball hit on the ground, but a foul ball, 1-2 now. Now the 1-2 pitch. That misses, and we're even at 2-2. Go ahead runs in scoring position here with one away. Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Up next,
good pitch there, and that was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
Alec Mills, the 6'4" right-hander, comes in out of the bullpen to do the pitching.
Number 30, Alec Mills.
So now to the plate, Trent Grisham. Well outside with the curveball for a ball. Outside part of the plate, the changeup is in there. Go-ahead runs in scoring position here with two down. Hit out towards second. Scooped up. They'll whip this one to first in time, and that ends the inning. Padres leave one, still all square at 4 apiece. Tim Hill comes on to start the home 10th, and he's just hoping to get this one into the 11th inning. And that brings up Javi Baez. The winning run stands at second base. The 1-1 pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. Now the 1-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. Struck him out. Struck him out again, I should say. His third punch out of the game. Now the Cubs' four-hole hitter, Anthony Rizzo. Prior history in this matchup, not a big sample size, 0-1. The 1-1 pitch.
I mean, he's coming right after him, Matty. Three fastballs in a row.
Now the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a liner. That's in there. Base hit. Throw coming quickly, and the winning run moves up to third now with only one gone.
Matty, it's hard to say right here. I got to believe they dove into the scouting reports on every outfield arm. He did not take an aggressive pass coming around third base bag right there. So I just think the third base coach had to hold him.
Next to stand in is Wilson Contreras. His day at the plate hasn't amounted to much, 0-4, but this is a great opportunity to make amends.
Well, when your team really needs you like they need it right here, you have to be able to put your personal struggles out of your mind. Right now is all that matters.
Possible winning run just 90 feet away here, one away. 1-1 pitch and a good sinker there, but he can't find the zone. 2-1.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now the 2-1. Just off the inside part of the plate, it's 3-1.
Couldn't be a whole lot better situation to hit in now. 3-1, 2-on. He's got to be thinking he's going to get a pitch he can drive right here.
The 3-1 pitch. A drive to left. Get out of here. Get out of here. Gone. They win it. Santa Maria. So a three-run blast to straightaway left, and none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Hey, when you get to extra innings, you're looking to piece together a rally or scratch any runs you can across the plate. But he says, hey, to heck with that. I'm going to do it with one swing of the bat. So a walk-off home run ends this thing in extras. That was fun.
Seven to four is the final score in tonight's game. Alec Mills takes home the win. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is the final line score tonight. First for the victorious Chicago Cubs. 7 runs on 12 hits.